they're kind of used everywhere. And so because they don't break down, we're now finding them everywhere. These are chemicals where the more you look, the more you find. Because they were so ubiquitous in commercial and industrial products in the 20th century. These were used in nonstick skillets, in fabrics, in fire retardants, in rain jackets, food packaging. They're kind of used everywhere. And so because they don't break down, we're now finding them everywhere. The reason why they don't break down very easily is the bonds, the chemical bonds on these compounds are extremely strong, and they don't break apart very easily. They are durable. They are built that way. They were built for durability and to prevent things from interfering with them. So there have been health studies linking exposure to PFAS compounds to hormonal disruptions, cancers of the testicles and kidney, thyroid disease, high cholesterol. So there's this range of effects that have been seen, and they've been seen at very small concentrations. Think back a trillion seconds in the course of human history, how far back that goes. And it goes back more than 30,000 years. And that's before we invented agriculture, before we domesticated dogs, a really long time. So a part per trillion is basically a sneeze in the span of human civilization. But it's these sneezes, these parts per trillion at that concentration that is concerning for health professionals. So we're finding effects at parts per trillion concentrations. And there's very few contaminants that we regulate that at that level. There are maybe 6 to 10 states that have had some sort of regulatory action around PFAS, and that ranges from levels that you would notify homeowners if it was found in groundwater to requirements on drinking water systems.